So it's pretty much the version that you are familiar with on PS4, maybe on Xbox. So it's a console port. We increased the UI slightly, so you see it's really like to the very maximum that we can do. It's still small, but it's readable, so obviously it's a console game. We hit the hangar now. We still have some credits from our previous run, so we can spend credits on this. Excuse me. So energy is very important, just like the stamina, as it would be in an RPG. So we have three ships. This is the ship of the expansion. Mm-hmm. So on Switch we will have the expansion included in one package, so you get the whole thing. And so this is the Sentinel. It's very good for electronic warfare, like can deploy decoy. And can EMP, has an EMP generator, so you can stun enemies. And this one is our tank. It's a gunship, obviously, has a turret on top. It's very heavy, lots of armor, but it's slow, it's clunky. And this one is the Scout, my personal favorite. So it's small, nimble, super fast, good for hit and run operations. It can cloak, it can even teleport. And has a shock rifle, so it's very good for long distance attacks. This interceptor, so it's kind of the working horse. So it's very versatile. It's good at everything, but not exceptionally good at anything. And we take this one for a spin.
Cool.
Yeah, we still have some credits. Don't care. We go for easy because it's a roguelike. It's tough. So if you're new, we highly recommend you go for easy. Learn a bit how the game works before you work your way up to normal or higher difficulty. As I said, as a roguelike, if you die, you start from the beginning. Mm-hmm. But you can spend the credits. Then you'll be better off the next time. Put in. Change to first person view here, copied view, first person, third person. I prefer third person.
Yeah.
I'm using the weapon overdrive right now, so we deal more damage. Hang on. There you are. All right, switch the weapon. The Gatling gun deals more damage to the hull, but only effective if the shields are down. And he's almost dead. Come on. So what we will still add here is like that you can adjust the amount of aim assist that you're getting, because with the small controllers it is a bit harder. So you see I'm fairly slow at switching weapons, which is key. But as always, it's just a matter of getting used to it, so I'm getting better. There you go.
Nice.
So then you collect your loot. You see we have a pretty solid frame rate. We have about 30 frames per second, so it's 720p, 100% screen percentage. If it's docked, we have better shadow quality, better anti-aliasing, better visual effects, and better post-processing. But its frame rate stays the same, pretty much. So there's a storyline involved. It takes about 20 hours to complete. The side missions from the expansion are included, as I said. Also the fourth ship. If you want to unlock everything, beat the entire game, it's about 40, 50 hours. And the digital release will be in December. And the physical release in January, February, because it takes so long to build the cartridges. But we wanted to come out this year. Made sure that for the holiday season, the game Everspace is available. All right, so I will not attack this station here because these are my friends. If I attack them to get some fuel, they will be mad at me and I'd be dead in an instant. Mm-hmm. So the yellow guys here, those are your friends. Yeah. If you're on attack, it's a good tactic to take the combat to them and they will help you. But obviously we won't attack them here. So I saw an enemy over here. We boost over there. It's just a drone. Drones deal a lot of damage, but don't have shields, at least not in the beginning, so it's good to take them down quickly. like that. And once you're done in a sector, you aim for the jump coordinates that takes you to, unless there's an asteroid in your way, that takes you to the next section. Everything is procedurally generated, so every time you play the game, it's slightly different. Each sector has a different look and layout, different number of enemies. If you progress further in the game, you can unlock additional information for each sector, like what's the threat level, is there a natural hazard, and more detailed information along the way. In total, we have six sectors that have like up to 15 locations each, and then there's the seventh sector, which is like one location. This is where the end fight takes place, and it takes about at the beginning it takes up to 2 hours to get there. Later on, a speed run can be done within less than 15 minutes if you're fully equipped and everything, and if you know the game by then. All right. Okay, this guy, we take down the shields. And once the shields are down, it's also a good idea. Oops. Okay, we got some missiles in coming, but we've got missiles as well. Come on. I'm far too far away, that's why. Now I'm getting him. All right, come on. So shields are down, and then we launch a missile. Oop. This should do it. Almost. Come on. Our shields are up. Not forever. Alright. So this is how it works. Another guy. Maybe we should use our weapon overdrive. Yes. Dealing more damage. Rockets. Off you go. This is how it works. Oh. So you see, even if there's combat, his frame rate is still good. We're pretty much done. We ported the game to 4.20, Unreal Engine 4.20, to take full advantage of the improvements for Switch. So this is why we have a really good frame rate now. We'll submit for final approval in October. So we're good to go for the holiday season.
Cool. And how was it to port the Unreal 4 engine? Is it hard in Switch?
To Switch? We had to do a lot of optimization. Like, all the projectiles and the enemies are flying, so we had to combine that to reduce the draw calls. Because it's the CPU is not as powerful as it is on typical consoles. So that took a while, but once we did that, including migrating to 4.20, that really did the job for us.
Yeah, it looks amazing on a handheld.
Yeah. But of course, it was a great benefit for us that we had a console version already.
Yeah.
So in total time, I think half a year working on that, one guy, full time.
Okay.
Yeah. But I think it's worth it. It paid off. So we want to make sure that that the experience is really good. Showed the crafting menu yet. That's something we should do.
Okay.
So while this is all in combat, you see that I'm constantly using missiles and whatnot, and you collect resources. Haven't done that yet. And then you go to the crafting menu. This is where you have all your equipment and where you can upgrade your weapons if you have enough resources, but we don't have enough resources yet.
Okay.
And if you run out of missiles, you can go here and build new. Still have some. Same goes for this one. I'm not used to the layout yet. I played on PS4 all the time, so it's slightly different. Then you have your active devices, passive devices, and you can create consumables, and this is what you do in here. If you take damage, you have to fix your hull with using nanobots, and then there are ship components that require nanobots and a certain amount of resources. So which is why it's very important that you also explore the levels and gather all the resources that are available.
Cool.
Yeah. I guess that's pretty much it.
Yeah. Thank you.
All right.